Hey guys, so today we are going to try to understand a very simple concept, that is the lac operon. So we'll try to understand the operon concept, what is inducible operon, because lac operon is one. Then we'll try to understand the structural genes and the function of the repressor and how it activates or inactivates a lac operon. So let's get right into first a few definitions that we'll have to talk about. So what is an operon after all? So an operon is simply a cluster of genes. And this cluster of genes will be doing or controlling a key character. For example, the lac operon, this controls the breakdown of lactose. You know, breakdown of lactose. Now, you very well know that lactose is a disaccharide. Right, it's a disaccharide which is made up of glucose and galactose. So if the whole cluster of genes function, then we'll have a functional breakdown of lactose to give the energy. Now this is an inducible operon. What does that mean exactly? The inducible operon simply means that it can be induced, that means it can be provoked to function upon the presence of a substance. In this case, that particular activating substance is lactose itself. And this makes sense, right? If the bacteria has lactose in its surrounding, then it should be able to use this lactose to obtain energy. So that actually makes sense. Now there has to be a repressor protein. Now what's a repressor protein? Suggests that it is going to secrete or make a protein that will inhibit transcription of the operon, and hence the lactose breakdown will not occur. Now let us try to understand some functional components of this operon. So first, you are going to have the structural genes, meaning the genes which are going to produce some proteins that are actually going to produce a function, that is the lactose breakdown. So the ones we will be talking about is Lac Z, Lac Y and Lac A. Now these three genes code different enzymes one after the other. So you have Lac Z that codes beta galactosidase, that is going to break the lactose into glucose and galactose. And then you have Lac Y, which gives a permease that allows the lactose to get inside the cell. And finally, you have Lac A. Lac A makes a transacetylase. We do not know exactly the function of Lac A. Nevertheless, that is important. Now, this little region is a promoter where the transcription will start, the RNA polymerase will bind, and this is the operator. Now, it's very important to understand that this is the place where the repressor will bind. Now, binding of repressor needs its creation, and obviously the creation will be done by a special gene called LacI. So remember, this LacI is not a part of the operon. The functional unit of the operon starts from the promoter, ends at LacA. LacI will code for the repressor protein, which, unless inactivated, will bind to the operator and stop transcription. Why it will stop transcription? Because in this case, your RNA polymerase cannot proceed and transcribe the genes Z, Y, and A. Now, just to summarize and recapitulate everything that we have covered so far, we have three genes, A, Y, and Z, each giving a functional enzyme. And if there is no lactose, without lactose, LacI is going to produce a repressor protein. The repressor protein will bind to the operator region and will inhibit working of RNA polymerase. Right now, what will happen if there is lactose in the medium? So if there is lactose, the lactose is going to bind to the repressor protein. So this is lactose. So lactose, because of the binding, the shape of the repressor protein is gonna change. Now, this is an allosteric isomer. Remember, allosteric isomer. So the protein's shape has been changed. Now, because of the shape change, it cannot bind to operator. Now, because it cannot bind to operator, the RNA polymerase will bind. So RNA polymerase will bind. It used to bind previously, but it could not proceed because there was a block at the operator region caused by the repressor protein. But now that there is no repressor protein, there won't be any block, and the RNA polymerase would proceed, producing the enzyme beta galactosidase, galactoside permease, and transacetylase, and hence they would have the capability now to break down lactose and hence get the energy from it. So I hope the components of this operon and how it functions are clear to you. Thank you. Now, a key thing about the way the repressor is acting here also needs to be understood, because this is an example of negative control. Why we say negative control? Because the repressor proteins inhibits the binding of a progressing of RNA polymerase and inhibits the transcription. So this is an example of negative control. Now the lac operon is also under a positive control. That means binding of something is going to help the operon to produce more. Let us try to understand that. As it happens, the affinity of RNA polymerase toward this piece of DNA is usually low. So, as it happens, if you do not have glucose, if the amount of glucose is less, that leads to an increase of a molecule called CAMP, that is cyclic adenosine monophosphate, right? Now, CAMP binds with CAMP receptor protein and forms a complex. Now, this complex binds to the promoter region and increases the affinity for RNA polymerase. Now, this actually makes sense, because if the concentration of glucose is low, I'm telling my operon to act faster to allow more affinity for RNA polymerase and hence transcribe the genes so that lactose can be used if it is available in the surrounding. On the other hand, if the concentration of glucose is high, then CAMP will reduce and hence the complex will reduce and the affinity for RNA polymerase will also reduce. So this is an example of positive regulation, where the binding of a CAMP-CRP complex to the DNA increases the affinity for RNA polymerase and hence increases the transcription. So we see that the lac operon is operated, or I can say controlled, by both negative and positive ways. Negative by the repressor protein and positively by the CAMP-CRP complex. Well, I hope this helps.
We hope you like this video. Press subscribe, thumbs up, and stay geekly.